Hello everyone, welcome to TechEQA channel. So we are going to start like about TestNG. So what is TestNG? So basically TestNG is a testing framework which is like inspired from JUnit and NUnit. They have added some more feature on top of JUnit and they have created TestNG. So like how can we integrate with the project that we are going to see now. So for that purpose, let me create a Java project. My TestNG project. Here we have to add the TestNG plugin. Before that, we need to install the TestNG. Go to Help, Eclipse Marketplace, so once it loading, something is loading actually. So once it load, we have to search here TestNG. Just a second. So marketplace is taking time to load actually. So like if you don't know how to install marketplace, let's search and it will show here the option like install TestNG, something like that. Anyway, I will show you. It's loading now still. So once you're done, you will get an option here. Right click on the project, go to properties, configure build path, Java build path. In add library, you can see TestNG here. If you haven't seen TestNG, you have to go to marketplace. If you see, just click on that and in just attach here, apply and close it. Okay. Let me open. I think marketplace is still opening. Yeah, here it's TestNG. It will search from the repository and it will show you the suggestion here. So once you get it, you have to click on install on the TestNG. In my case, I have already installed, that's why I'm able to add the TestNG. So once you add the TestNG here, you can see TestNG, that library here itself. It's taking a long time. Okay, that's okay. Let it load. So let me create one package to get practice. My package. Yeah, TestNG is showing on the marketplace. So installed. If you haven't installed, install, restart, then TestNG will be able to attach in any project. Okay, so there is another option from the Maven also. If you are using Maven project, there is nothing to do. Just go TestNG Maven dependency. The first link only you can get the dependency. Yeah, this one you have to copy and put into pom.xml. That's it. So now we have created standalone project. We have to attach it with library. Okay, go to right click, click create a class. My TestNG learning, something like that. Okay, I have a public class my learning. For example, if it is Java, you should have main method, right? You should have main method. This out. Then only you will be able to run the program as Java program. Run as Java. Now you can run, it will print hello. If you are going to remove the main method, we don't want. I have to write public my test. So I'm not going to return anything. Public void my test. So from my test. Here, if you are trying to print something, you can't run it actually. So with help of TestNG, we can run this test. Think this as a test. What we have to do, we have to add one annotation. called @test. It will ask you to import the test annotation. Once you're done, see, you can see as a testng test. You can see from my test. Okay. For example, if you have multiple test cases, my test 2, my test 3, something like that. Here also I will enter 1, 2, 3. My test 1, 2, 3. If you remove this test annotation, it won't run. Actually, this is the basic annotation, which is the first annotation. We use it everywhere. So we have a report also, kind of a report. Maybe what you can do, just refresh. You will get test output folder. Go here. Just click on open with the web browser. You can see here the HTML report. 2 tests are passed. But actually we have 3. Here we haven't added any test cases or like test annotation. So this won't be considered as a test. So we can the another way of running test is from XML. So for this purpose, you have to create a XML file like this. First, it should have suit, test, class, classes. Here, what are the classes you want to run? So here I have my package. My package dot my testng learning. So instead of, I will copy the file name. You can type it like that. Okay. Once you're done, you can just run it from here itself. Testng file, run as testng suit. You can see from my test 1, from my test 3. Okay. So you can run it in the both way. So this is how we can use our @test, and we can run it from both way, from here as well as from the testng.xml, that like we'll call it as a test suit. Okay guys, maybe next video we can see how to use more annotation and lot more feature from the testng. Thanks for watching.